Happy Monday, you guys. Oh my gosh, I'm still like, this is what I put on at 5 a.m. this morning and how I rolled out of bed, done my workouts, everything. But I wanted to check in with you all today. It's an exciting day. It's Monday, which is your fresh start and new beginning for the week. It's the week of Thanksgiving and a holiday that so many of us cherish, but I also know that brings some stress and anxiety too. And so here, I'm just gonna set this down. So I wanted to be here for you today to give you, I guess, a positive focus for this week and some really great tangible action steps as you go into traveling and spending time with family and or just hanging out and keeping a low profile at home. I know that this week everybody celebrates and in so many different ways. And so I wanted to make sure that you knew how grateful I am of each of you and how thankful I am that I get to show up every day and be your coach. I just want to let you know that. I'm so grateful and thankful that we have Shakeology, especially during this time of the year, because a lot of times we aren't doing awesome at nutrition and self-care and giving ourselves the right ingredients. I know in Indiana, I'm not getting enough of my vitamins and nutrients just because I'm not outside as much. I'm not eating fresh fruits and vegetables as much, and I'm not getting as much sunshine and activity. And so I'm so thankful that I get to nourish my body with Shakeology, especially during the winter months. And when we're going to be maybe indulging in more sugar, more carbohydrates, I'm really thankful and grateful for Beachbody On Demand, because our workouts and our nutrition, but our workouts especially, will travel with us and can go with us anywhere. So it doesn't matter if maybe you go somewhere that doesn't have equipment or you're in a really tight, small space, you can find a workout to do. And I highly recommend that no matter what, especially this week, you are really intentional about getting your workouts in. Even if you have to do something different and on within another program that maybe doesn't require equipment or doesn't require you to make a lot of noise while you're working out because you're in a small space, but make it a priority. Like, even if you're in a hotel room, even if you're in a small space or staying in someone's home in a guest room, that you do your workout anyway, because I know that when you make that leap and you do something uncomfortable that you've never done before, but for yourself and for the greater good of your goals and your health, that there's a lot of power and empowerment that comes from doing that. I know the first time that I did a workout in my mom's basement, it felt weird. I'd never done that before in my life. Her space wasn't set up for a workout. I didn't have everything I needed, but I did it anyway, and I felt incredible. And then my mom was like, "What are you doing? That's kind of cool that you worked out in my home. Like, maybe I could do the same, you know?" And then you're also showing other people around you and your family that, like, you're like, take me serious. Like, I'm in on this. This is not a one and done thing. Like, this girl showing up, 2020 is my year of perfect vision and clarity of how I want to show up for my life and live a, you know, fit, healthy, confident life. And I'm going to do it. And I'm going to make any space my workout space. That's what's really cool about what we do. It goes anywhere with us. You know, get outside, get fresh air, take walks, those kinds of things. Okay. I also want you to be really intentional with your water intake this week. When we travel, when we indulge, when we eat foods off our plan, you know, be really intentional with your water intake. And so wake up in the morning, drink 10 to 12 ounces of water right off the bat, because that gets your digestion started in a positive way. It wakes up your body and it starts you off hydrated, especially because we're eating foods that are probably made with Velveeta. That's not a cheese product, right? That has way more, my grandma, my peoples, they just salt things, right? And it's not pink Himalayan salt, right? It's whatever, you get it. It's not our same ingredients. It's not our same foods. So, you know, it's going to be something that we're going to feel differently in our bodies. It might make us feel heavy. It might inflame us, feel us bloated. And so more water is going to offset that and help you flush your body so much better. So 12 ounces in the morning, as soon as you get up, and then drink water, a lot of water, before you eat any of those indulgent meals. Okay, like 10, 12 ounces, drink your water before you have that. It's gonna make you feel fuller faster, and it's also gonna help you process and get rid of the toxins in that food a little bit faster, okay? And then when it comes to dessert, you know what? My mom makes pumpkin pie once a year,
And my Aunt Nancy makes this amazing, like, fruit-based cobbler that's so good once a year. I'm totally going to have some. I'm going to put a few different desserts on my dessert plate. I'm not going to eat it until it's gone. I'm going to have a few tastes of it. I'm going to share it with my husband, and I'm not going to sweat it. I'm not going to have any regrets whatsoever. I want you to enjoy those, your favorite things that happen just once a year. But I also don't want you to put food on your plate you don't love. You know, like when you look at the whole array of all the Thanksgiving, you know, fixins, if you don't love it, don't eat it. Like, I do not love cranberry sauce. I'm not going to put it on my plate. I do not love any kind of casserole that uses a cream of mushroom soup. I'm not going to put it on my plate. I'm not going to put things on my plate because I think I have to, and because that's what I think is expected of me, or because I think that someone's feelings may get hurt if I don't have it. We are all grown ass women here, and we can all make decisions for our health, and we shouldn't do anything or eat something to feel like we need to make people happy or to do it because that's what we're supposed to do. You do your thing, boo. Okay. And please, please, please don't eat because you have to or because it's expected. It's okay to say, I don't like that, so I'm not going to have it, and that's okay. It's also okay to say no, thank you. It's also okay to say, oh, I'm good on dessert right now. I'll have some later. And maybe you mean that or not. You'll see how you feel later. It's okay to pass. It's okay to say no, thank you. It's okay to say not right now. Okay. Now, this is a tip that I really have adopted, and I feel it now because I've learned this idea from the 2B mindset, and I actually feel this way now, is that when we go into social and celebratory, you know, occasions like the holidays, when we go into it and there's a big meal attached to it, that's our culture, is we eat food to celebrate, right? Which it's not really what we're there for. I'm showing up at my Aunt Nancy's house to be with my family. There happens to be a meal there, but I'm not there for the food. I'm there for the company. I'm there to catch up with my cousins. I'm there to give giant bear hugs and to let my kids play with their cousins and to catch up and to tell stories and to share photos and talk about Disney and whatever. I'm there for the company and the conversations and not the food. And so the food will not be my primary focus while I'm there. So I'm choosing not to hang out in the kitchen. I'm going to choose to hang out in the living room and have conversations. And I'm also going to take cards, deck of cards, and also going to take dominoes so that we have something to do that doesn't involve eating while we're there. And we can all sit around the table and play dominoes. We can sit around the table and play euchre and have fun together. And so I want you to think about that too. Like, what is the vibe at your event? You know, is it something where it's just all about the food? Can you bring a new vibe and something new to the table this year? Can you bring your own intentions to your Thanksgiving gatherings and whatnot, where it's not just food focused, but it's focused on conversations. It's focused on being with your family. It's focused on gratitude. Can you look up online and get a fun activity to do with your family, with the kiddos? Can you play bingo? Like, you know, like we went and got a bingo set, super cheap, found one on Amazon and took it 1 year to the family Christmas. And everybody had so much fun playing bingo together. And it was something new. It was something different. It brought the family together and it took us out of the kitchen and into the living room to do something else. So I hope that these tips are really helpful for you. I would love to hear, you know, maybe what struggles you're having, what intentions you have going into the holidays. If you all have a favorite tradition that you could share, that would be awesome, so that we could hear maybe some great ideas of how you guys focus more on family and gratitude and community rather than the food over the holidays as well. I hope this was helpful, you guys. I love you to pieces. I'll see you later.